This is Spend Wise Moms with a video on price books. What is a price book? A price book is a record of prices for things you buy most often. It's used to compare the prices between different stores to see which store offers the lowest price for your items. Why is the price book valuable? A price book is a great reference book to shop more wisely and save money on your grocery bill. You know where to purchase your grocery items for the best price. There can be a big difference in prices between stores for the same items. How do I make a price book? You can use a notebook, paper and pencil, or an electronic device. Google Docs or Excel are programs that work well for this. There's some apps that are made to keep track of prices, but making a price book is very easy to do for yourself. You can make a simple price book or a detailed price book. Make your price book the way it works best for you. It can be done in alphabetical order, categorized by meats, grains, canned food, frozen food, or whatever way you like. Under each category, you can also include more details like cuts of meat, for example. Things you can record in a price book are the date, the item, the store, the brand, the price, and the unit price. When making a price book, list the groceries you purchase most often, depending on whether you want a simple price book or a detailed price book. Proceed accordingly. A simple price book only keeps track of the lowest price for each item and the store that offers that price. For example, if you're writing down milk and the lowest price you find is $1.99 for a gallon, at Walmart, that's what you write down. If you find cottage cheese for $1.28 for 16 ounces at Town and Country, you write that down. Now, if you see an item that's lower than the price you have in your price book, you simply erase the current information and replace it with the new information. A detailed price book would show several stores and the prices they charge for each item. For example, you would put the item on the left, and on the top you would write store 1, store 2, store 3, store 4. The stores could be like Albertsons, Rosauer's, Smith's, and IGA, for example. Once you are done recording the prices, you will see that some stores charge more than others for the same thing. You can easily see which price is the least expensive. You can use this information to buy your grocery items at the store that has the best price. There are some stores that will match the prices of other stores. Going to one store saves time and is much more convenient. Find out if you need to bring in competitor store ads to match prices, if that is what you choose to do. The really nice thing about having a price book is that it provides information to make better decisions. As time goes on, you'll be able to spot a good price on something without having to refer to your price book each time. But this is really a great tool when you're starting out and trying to save money. To be able to gather the different prices you need, one thing you can do is to write down some of the prices when you do your regular shopping at each store. This way you don't have to make a special trip to the store to gather your prices. Another thing you can do is to look online to get this information. You can also use past receipts to collect information. Next time you go shopping, use your price book to compare the prices ahead of time so you can get the best deals. When you have certain pantry items that are running low, check your price book for things you need and stock up at the lowest price. Prices change, so a price book needs to be updated on a regular basis. Try to buy only when prices are the lowest. Make sure you use a pencil when marking in a price book because then you can erase the current price if a better one comes along. An erasable red pencil can also be used to highlight or circle the lowest price for each item as well. If you're using a computer, you can easily delete the current price and write in the new price. Grocery items go on sale in cycles, usually every 12 weeks. This means that if beans are on sale now, they will probably go on sale again in 12 weeks. Be careful not to buy way too much. You only want to buy what you'll use before the expiration date, or you'll just end up wasting money. If you want to shop at just one store, you can see who has the best prices overall Find out if there are any stores in your area that match prices. It may not seem like a lot to save 25 cents off a can of beans or corn, but it adds up. If you buy corn each week, that is $13 savings over the year, or the equivalent of 26 free cans of corn. A price book can be a great tool to help you save money on your grocery bill.